Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Life Science with Nivedita. So this video is all about how to write a literature review and how to do a literature survey. Because once you started your project, dissertation and also research, the first thing you have to do is the literature survey, right? So because our guide will suggest to do the literature survey, literature review, so then only we started our project work and all, right? So what does it mean and what are the things inside what are the things are there inside this literature review and what are the steps you have to follow while doing the literature survey. So each and everything you'll discuss through this video. And also at last, we will discuss one article, okay? We'll take on an article and also we discuss each and every steps, okay? So because that will help you to write a literature review while doing your project as well as dissertation and also research, okay? So now started. So the first thing we have to do means we have to know the literature review definition, right? So first of all, the definition of the literature review is, okay, so selection as well as collection of available knowledge and the available document for a particular topic of study, okay? Or literature review is an overview of the previously published works on a specific topic, okay? So here, what it is defined means it is a selection and also it is a collection. So what selection and collection? The available knowledge and also available document in a particular topic to study, right? So once you started your project, you have to take one particular topic and you have to search that particular topic in the literature survey, right? So that's why the definition of the literature review is, it is an overview of the previously published work on a specific topic. The topic is which you are going to take, no? So that topic, so the literature review is, it is a overview. Okay, so it is an overview, the previously published works on a specific topic. Okay, so this is definition. So now move on to the sources. Okay, so when come to the sources of literature review, there are two sources. The first one is primary source and secondary source. So primary source is nothing but the research report or dissertation is written by the person who is conducted the experiment. Okay, means the person who conducted the experiment itself writing the research report. Okay, so when come to the secondary source, the person who conducts the research is different as well as the person who is writing the report or dissertation is different. Okay, so these two are the sources of literature review. Okay, so now move to the resources. So you selected the topic, right? So after selecting the topic, you have to do the survey, right? So how to do survey? The rich sources are internet, journals, magazines, newspapers, conference papers, and some books, right? So one, for example, any topic you have to take for particular project and dissertation. So the first thing you have to do, you have to select, you have to search each and everything which is related to your topic, right? Through internet, through journals, through magazines, through newspaper, through conference papers, through books, okay? So each and everywhere you have to search related to the topic, okay? So now, steps of a literature review. So what are the steps you have to follow while doing your literature review? The first thing is what? The first and foremost thing is you have to select a topic, okay? Any topic which is favored to you, which you are interested to do research, to a project or to dissertation, whatever. So the first thing is you have to select a topic. Okay, so after selecting the topic, you have to search the literature, means what are the previous studies which are done related to your topic. You have to search that literature. Okay, so after that, you have to develop the argument, means while searching the literature, while searching the particular information regarding to your topic, you have to develop the argument, means you get to know like what are the results, the previously research things were got, and also what are the changes happen. Okay. You have to argue each and everything. So after that, you have to survey the literature, means you have to search. So based on your topic, you have to search the literature. After that, you have to develop the argument. So after developing the argument, you have to survey the literature, means you have to search each and everywhere based on your topic. Okay, related to your topic research, you have to survey the literature, means what are the articles published, what are the studies going on, or still is studies going on a particular topic which you are selected, like that you have to do survey on that particular topic. Okay, so after that you have to critique the literature, means you have to inquire, you have to inquire the literature, whatever you got while survey. Okay, studies, whatever the literature you got, you have to inquire the literature. Okay, so after inquiry, what you have to do, you have to write the review. Okay, so select the topic, You have to search the literature. So after searching the literature, you have to develop the argument. So after developing the argument, you have to survey the literature. You have to search your topic, particular topic, everywhere. Okay. So then you have to evaluate. You have to evaluate the literature. So after you evaluate, you have to write the review. Review means what? You have to write in your own words. Okay. Whatever you understood while searching, while developing the argument, while surveying, while enhancing, and also while inquiring. Okay, so each and every step, whatever information you got, you have to write in your own words. That is nothing but review of literature. Okay, so now move to the further steps. So see, the first step is what? Identifying the concept of research problem and identify the key terms to search. Okay, what are the key terms? For example, I'm taking my dissertation topic. So when I was in MSc, I have done my dissertation on the topic, that is papaya leaf extract to treat dengue fever. Okay, means what are the means effect of papaya leaf in the during the dengue fever. Okay, this is my topic. So while identifying, for example, I have to review that particular topic means. So the first thing I have to do is what? I have to search related to that topic. So the key terms means what? The key terms is, the first thing is papaya leaf, then dengue fever, right? So in my topic, that these two things are key terms. Okay, so it depends on your topic which you have taken. Okay, so when come to my topic, that is papaya leaf and also dengue fever is the key term. So key terms is nothing but what? I have to search that particular terms. Okay, so next thing is what? So after getting the key terms, I have to search over that. Okay, so after that, I have to identify the relevant sources, means in internet, through magazines, through journals. Okay, so everywhere I used to search that key terms, not only the papaya leaf, not only the dengue fever, but both also. Okay, so both thing I have to search. So after searching, I have to analyze and synthesize properly. Okay, so after searching, I got some information, I got some articles. So through that information, I have to analyze and I have to synthesize in a particular manner. Okay, so after that, I have to writing the literature. Okay, you have to write the literature in your own words, whatever you understand while reading the articles, while surveying. Okay, so you have to write that the literature in your own words. Okay, so after that, what? Addition and deletion. Okay, if any addition is if anything is added, you have to add. If anything is deleted, you have to delete. Okay, so that thing you have to do in the next step. So after that, conclusion. So after done all these things, you have to conclude the topic, right? So you got some results, you got some experiment. After doing some experiment, you got some result and all. So you have to enter each and everything. So after, at last, you have to conclude that, right? So you have to do conclusion. And the last and important part is reference, okay? Because in the YY and all, many students will stuck in this reference itself, okay? Because the reference is very, very important. And in reference, there is a particular, specific manner is there. So to write the reference, there is a specific manner is there. You have to follow that. So that I will explain while explaining the article. Okay. So now move on to the next thing. So this is the literature review process. That is, you have to collect the articles. So after collection, you have to read the literature. So after reading the literature, you have to summarize the state of research that is regarding to a topic. Okay. So then you have to identify the gaps, relations, and also variations while reading many articles, which were written by many authors, right? So many research are going on on a particular topic, right? So that's why there are many researchers, many articles we got. So you have to identify the gaps, relations, and also variances. Okay. So after that, you have to suggest for next further steps. Okay. So now see, this is the standard format of literature in literature review. Okay. Means here that is like a head, body, and also tail. Apart from these three things, there are still many are there. So while explaining the article, we'll discuss. Okay. So these three are main important, that is head, body, and also tail. So the head is what? Introduction. Okay. So in this introduction, you have to add background or history, which is related to a topic. Okay. And also aims of the research, and also how the research findings can lead to the actual dissertation question. Okay. So now comes the discussion. It is the middle part, like whatever experiment you done, what are the methods and materials you follow, okay, and what are the result you get, statistics method. So each and everything we have to fill in this discussion part. Okay, that's why 80% word count will coming in this discussion part. Okay, so here you have to add analysis and evaluation of the literature and start discussion from journal or general or main subject area, that is in the paragraph format. Okay, so then lead same evaluation to the specific research problem. Okay, whatever you got the topic related to that topic, you have to evaluate to the specific research problem. Okay, so the last thing is conclusion, that is the tail part. So here you have to summarize the main points, whatever results you got, whatever, you know, experimental result you got. So each and everything you have to summarize. Okay, so these three are important part in the literature review. So now we move on to the one, we'll take a specific article, then we move. Okay, so now how to read an article and also how to search article in internet and all. There are many sites are there. Okay. So the popular and also which I used is PubMed. Okay. It is nice because here plenty of articles we got. So that's why I go through the PubMed. So here this is the PubMed. You just click on that. Okay. So while clicking, we got somehow like this. Okay. So here you have to search here, right? So here you have to search the topic or, you know, articles related to your topic. Okay. So when it comes to my thing, I already mentioned, right? My topic is on papaya leaf extract to treat dengue fever. Okay. So I just simply search over here. I am okay. Just click on the search. So here I got, see, many things. See, not only one article, I got many articles like this. So just click on the first thing. Okay. So I click on that, I got this thing. Just click on that. Okay. So by clicking on that, you got this article. See. Okay. So here I got article which is related to my specific topic. So like this, you have to search regarding on your topic. Okay. So you got articles. So just go through that. So where come to the article. So see here. Okay. So this is the title. Okay. This is the title of the article, that is papaya extract to treat dengue. Okay, because it's related to some of my topic, right? So that's why I just click on this article to read. Okay, so I just go through this, and here each thing will mention a specific thing. So these two are authors, okay, and this is the journal. Okay, through this journal, this article is published, and here this is issue. Okay, this is issue, page number, date. Okay, each and everything you have to read. This is important while applying the reference. Okay, so the first and foremost thing in the article is abstract, right? So what is abstract? What does it indicates means here, abstract means the entire summarizing thing, whatever you done in the entire article, right? So the entire article thing they have to summarize in the abstract part. That is somehow not like introduction, but here the entire thing what you have done in the entire article, they have summarized it in through the abstract. Okay, like, you know, a trailer, no, in the after before releasing the movie, they will release one trailer, right? So like this, abstract is like that. Okay, somehow like trailer. So each and everything, what are the things containing in the article, so that will they will mention in the abstract. Okay, so this is abstract. Okay, so now this is introduction. Okay, means you have to introduce your topic, right? So for example, when come to my case, the papaya leaf and dengue is the key term. So I have to introduce both the things, that as well as the dengue fever, about the dengue fever, and also see, this is about dengue fever, it is this is transmitted to mosquito, blah blah blah. Okay, so then come to the papaya leaf, about the papaya, its family, and it has some that, you know, what is the important thing to treat dengue, what are, you know, what is the effectiveness, what are the thing it has in that leaf. So each and everything I have to introduce. Okay, small introduction. So after that, come to the discussion part, that is what are the things you have to take, the materials and methods. Okay, means I have to take the leaf, extract that, you know, components to treat the dengue. So each and everything I have to mention. See, this is about materials and methods, and also here this is the review. Okay, what are the authors, they've got the article's title and all. So now a brief overview. So here I have to overview both dengue as well as papaya leaf. So see here, this is about the dengue, about the dengue virus, and also the patient's complications, what are the complications observed, and about the thrombocytopenia. So here the main thing, okay, the main thing about this dengue fever is the papaya leaf they will use, right? So in while treating the papaya leaf, the thrombocytopenia level, okay, so that will increase. The main characteristic feature in the dengue fever is thrombocytopenia means the platelets count will be decreased. Okay, so while treating with the papaya leaf, the count will be increased. So that's why they used to use that papaya leaf to treat dengue. So like this, you have to relate to your specific topic. Okay, so you have to relate to a specific topic, then only you have to search. Okay, so see, this is about the thrombocytopenia and how this papaya plant will use to this particular dengue. Okay, which is what are the activities it got, each and everything like antioxidative, anti-inflammatory, it's, you know, hepatoprotective, like this. Many things it have, many activities it has. So you have to mention that. Okay. So after that, the mechanism of action of papaya extract in the dengue, you have to explain because related to project, right? So after that, studies in animals, you have to study on the animals and also studies in the humans. Okay. And also discussion. So at last, it is discussion or conclusion. Okay. So whatever the things we have to discuss, right? So each and everything we have to discuss or conclusion at the end. Okay. So the last but not the least, it is very important. Reference. Okay, so how to apply this reference means what are the articles you use to write the literature review, right? So all the reference you have to apply here, you have to write here. So there is a specific method, there is a specific, you know, method is there to write the reference, that is I will show. So you see, right? So this will represent what? Author name. Okay, so this will represent author name, and here this will represent the title. Okay, there's a specific manner is there. You have to write the reference in that manner itself. This is title, and also this is journal where the article is published, no? That journal, and also year. So after that, volume, that is journal issue. So after journal issue, you have to add volume. And also page number. This is the format. Okay, this is the format you have to follow while writing the reference. Okay, the first thing is you have to write author name. You have to write author name. So after writing the author name, you have to add title. After writing the title, you have to write the journal where the article is published. And also after journal, you have to mention year. Okay, so after year, the journal issue. If there is journal issue, you write. If there is not mentioned, you just skip it. Skip this part. Okay. So after journal issue, the volume and also the page number. Okay. So these steps you have to follow while writing the reference. Okay. So this is entire thing about literature review. So it is very easy because while doing the project, while doing the dissertations, it may confuse. But once you get to know, it is very easy. Okay, so you have to search the articles. You have to continuously have to read the articles. Okay, then only you get an idea. And the main thing, reference is main thing. You have to follow that specific manner while writing the reference. Okay, so I think it's clear. So if any doubts, if any queries regarding this review of literature and survey literature survey, so you can ask in the comment box. Okay, so. Thank you so much for watching. Okay. So, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. If you like this video, hit the like button. And thank you so much. Until next time, stay safe, stay healthy.